Skywatch Media News for September the 5th, 2019. Just recently, another earthquake struck off the Oregon coast at a depth of 3 miles. The quake was strong enough to send tremors some 460 miles from the epicenter. The latest event has residents on edge, as Oregon is located near the 700-mile-long fault known as the Cascadia Subduction Zone. The strong earthquake off the Oregon coast comes after more than 64 tremors have rattled California in just a 24-hour period, leading some to fear that the big one is finally coming. Their fears are certainly warranted now that the Pacific Northwest Seismic Network has issued a warning for the Puget Sound area near Seattle after a 4.6 quake rocked the area in July, one of the largest events in many years for this region. This, of course, comes on the heels of a pair of significant earthquakes that struck Southern California near the town of Ridgecrest. All of these events point to the heightened risk that a major seismic event is underway along the Cascadia Subduction Zone, which involves episodic tremors. When, and not if, the big one hits the Pacific Northwest, it will be lights out for Seattle and the surrounding regions. The Washington State Department of Natural Resources recently published a video simulation that shows how the state coastline would be impacted in the hours following a megathrust earthquake. It shows that large tsunami waves would barrel in and out of the Washington coast, including through inland waterways that connect to Seattle and its surrounding communities. The waves would be generally tall and devastating. Another concern is what's known as a trough. This is where water levels suddenly recede after a sea quake, followed by a rapid return ashore. An example of this is visualized in the massive 2004 Indian Ocean tsunami that pulled water out from the beach before sending it roaring back. Another concern is the fact that the Cascadia Subduction Zone is located right next to the Juan de Fuca tectonic plate, which plunges underneath the North American plate. A large section of the Juan de Fuca plate is missing underneath Central Oregon. It is tearing apart and splitting this plate about 93 miles below the surface. The fact that the plate is dying under Central Oregon has raised more concerns about how a cascading seismic event might impact the Pacific Northwest. In addition to the Cascadia, Seattle is also threatened by the seismically active Seattle Fault and the South Whidbey Island Fault. These fault lines combined are overdue for a significant earthquake. Hurricane Dorian will, in every practical sense, become known as one of the most powerful storms on record in the Atlantic. A storm with a uniquely incredible path that brought complete and utter destruction to the islands of the Bahamas, while sideswiping the southeastern seaboard of the United States, dumping incredible amounts of rain. This will be its legacy in the annals of tropical storms. Dorian has not only brought its share of anguish to all those in its path, but it has also brought along some eerie and chilling images of its fury and its grandeur. Astronauts aboard the International Space Station saw the power of Dorian. They had a unique vantage point from the rest of the world. One of those astronauts with front row seats was Nick Hague, who captured this image of the Eye of Dorian on September 2nd. A few hours later, there were more space images of Dorian posted on Twitter, including a chilling shot staring directly down into the hurricane's mighty jaws. On September 1st, the International Space Station flew over the Caribbean and captured amazing images of Hurricane Dorian from 260 miles in altitude, showing the sheer size of the Category 5 storm as it hit the Bahamas. The U.S. Air Force hurricane hunters that flew into the Eye of Dorian captured an eerily calm scene from within the destructive storm on September 1st. The video from the National Hurricane Center shows the enormity of the Category 5 storm as it approached the Abaco Islands, packing sustained winds of 185 miles per hour with gusts of 200 miles per hour. Above the immense swirling vortex could be seen an impressive lightning display as it continued on a path of destruction. Lightning flashes of this magnitude is an ominous indication of the increased strength of this magnificent storm. The NOAA satellite image captured on August 30th shows the continuous lightning associated with Dorian. In this depiction, the electrical currents have gone astray due to a sudden change in the inner core convection. This created small bursts of energy in the center of the storm. Dorian has become the fifth Category 5 storm in the Atlantic Basin in the past 4 years. It is tied for the second strongest landfall hurricane on record in the Atlantic, dating all the way back to 1935. Dorian remains a major Category 3 hurricane as of September the 5th, as it lashes the North and South Carolina coasts with torrential rains and strong winds. As you look to the heavens, know that the sky is vast. It is all-encompassing. Everything else is pale in comparison. Thanks for watching.